back to my channel and long time no speak. I think I took about a week off, so sorry for the lack of videos. I've just had a lot going on, like we all do, but I wanted to come on and go through some favourites with you. So this is my favourites at the moment in terms of fitness, beauty and skincare and things that I've discovered in the last few months that I'm loving. So if you wanted to see some, then keep watching. So I'm going to start with the fitness bits first, and I'll link everything down below for you guys in the old bottom bar, I don't know what you call it. So first of all, because obviously if you've watched some of my videos and you're on my Instagram, you'll know that I've recently got into running. I did my first 10k, so I did the Bristol 10k with 2 weeks training, and now I've got the bug. So I'm doing my next 10k at the end of June, and then I'm doing my half marathon, so I'm doing the Bristol half marathon in September. So I've just signed up for my training plan. The app I use is called Map My Run. It's by Under Armour, so it's the same people that do My Fitness Pal. So I just like the fact that it can all sync into my calories and my eating patterns. So I'm using Map My Run. I'd highly recommend it. I have been using the free version, but obviously now I need training plans. I have now just signed up. The subscription is £5.49 a month, so that's the one I've been using. I really enjoy it. So I've obviously picked up some bits that have helped me. So I quickly realised pretty shortly in to running that I needed more of a trainer, like a quite sturdy running trainer. I did have some other Pumas, but they felt a bit flat and kind of stiff, whereas I like to have a bit more of a bounce. So I actually got these from TK Maxx. These are, I think, the Puma Hybrid Rocket Trainers. I'll link the pair that I found below. I've absolutely been loving TK Maxx just in general, just because I found so many bargains. I did do a haul a couple of weeks ago, so you can see that. But these trainers are normally £110, but I got them for £40, size 4, and I just went for them because, one, I know they're running trainers, and two, they're just really great. So they're nice and sturdy. The way the sole is, sorry, it is going to look a bit dirty because obviously I've been running. I'm sorry also for touching it quite a lot. If anyone's got any like cleaning habits, that's probably not the best thing to see, but it feels really comfortable on. The sole inside are really supportive. I love the colour because I wear a lot of black and blue and grey whenever I train, so I'm loving those. I also got a workout set from TK Maxx. I did find it in stock on their website, so I'll link that down below for you. My mum and dad got it for me for my birthday. And it's very me, so it's a pink, black and grey camouflage set. The bra top, I think they got it in a medium, and it's by a brand called, I don't know how you say it, Kyadon? But they do have this brand on TK Maxx. And I obviously got the matching leggings as well. They do remind me of the Fabletics Power Hold leggings because they've got that waistband at the top, which I love because basically it sucks everything in, so I always look out for that style. And yeah, they're really cute. They're gonna again go with all my running clothes, and I just feel really trendy, and they're really good quality thick leggings, which is what we like, so I'll link them down below. My running belt at the moment, I have just ordered one to go on my arm. I normally just get all my like gadgets and whatever else from Amazon. So this is the belt that I'm using at the moment. I really like it because it's got loads of different pockets. It's by a brand called My Carbon. It was less than £10. I'm guessing this is going to glow in the dark if I ever run at night time. I haven't really needed to yet, but I know in winter I'll need that. It's got a nice big pocket there. It is actually supposed to store a water bottle, but I actually prefer to have all the different departments for my phone, my keys. So I normally keep my keys in that front pocket. Fits me really well. Obviously it's adjustable, and then it's got another little secret pocket at the back, so if you were running and you wanted to put, I don't know, your purse, lip balm, like, it's quite a good one, and it lasted me when I was running. My other thing, so I actually asked for these for my birthday. I can't quite justify spending £195 on the Apple ones. I might save up for them as a treat for myself, but I'm more worried about losing them or breaking them. So this is basically a copy of them from Amazon. Again, I'll link them down below. I think they were about £30 to £40. I got them in black because I think the white were out of stock. There's loads of different brands on Amazon website which basically sell a really similar version of these, but the reviews on these were really good. last really well. Basically, I didn't realise at first. I thought you had to plug them into here and then plug it into a USB, but no. Oh, no. So this is actually a charger pot. So you charge the pot via USB, but you can actually charge the headphones whilst they're in the box, which I think is genius. Sound quality is really good. They obviously are a lot more comfortable for me. I obviously still have my other wireless headphones, which I really love, but obviously when I'm working out, I do get sweaty, so I like to have it where, one, they stay in my ear, and two, they don't affect the back of my head. So I really like the case. They're great for walking, walking back from work, just doing anything really. So I love those. Weight training and resistant band work. Obviously, you know that I do the Kim French full body plan. Not paid, not sponsored, but I ended up buying her resistance band. She's just started selling them. I started with, I just bought two just to try them out. This is like the heavy and the super heavy. And then the one that I tend to use a lot, which I recently bought, is the medium. My other previous favourite resistance band was actually a CrossFit resistance band, and it was to a similar standard, but I actually think these are better. The reason why I like them is you can see on the inside, one, how this is the medium and it's pretty tough. And there's also grip on the inside, which means that it's not gonna fall off. Like, it's quite significant, like, gripping in there. So yeah, I absolutely love these, especially now in weight training and running. I kind of like to use resistance bands just for building my leg strength up even more, so I'm loving those. Another random thing I got for my birthday, which I thought I'd share. I need to go into Home Bargains and actually do a Home Bargains haul, but these are some fluffy sliders I got. They're really comfy, really soft. Sometimes with these fur sliders, the bit underneath can be really, like, tough and thick, but they're actually really soft, almost like smooth, like socks on the inside. So these are super comfy. They're from Home Bargains and they were £3.99. My mum just got them for me as a little kind of little gift to go in my birthday bag. So yeah, I love those. Gonna go on randomly, I think, to some skincare. At the moment, when I tend to run, I wear absolutely like minimal to no makeup, unless, like, today, obviously I've done my makeup for filming and for blogging. So what I'll most likely do is I'll just take my lashes off and leave the makeup on. But most of the time, I'm obviously going makeup free, so I want my skin to look nice. I'm really happy with how my skin's looking at the moment, and there's a few things that I've added in which I think are helping. So first of all, this is my absolute holy grail at the moment. It's the Misha Perfect Cover BB Cream, and I have shade number 23. I basically now, because my skin has got so smooth and so much better because of some of the other products I'm going to mention, my foundation at the moment, so if I'm running and I just want my skin to, you know, have a bit of a base and some colour on, I put this on. It's got SPF 42 in it, which is brilliant. And for a BB cream, it's actually quite, like, thick coverage. I would say it's like a medium to full coverage, because I've tried some BB creams before and they just don't even, like, I like to have coverage. And this makes your skin just look really healthy, naturally glowing, and yeah, it really suits my skin tone. I know, obviously, eventually, if I have photos in this, there is going to be flashback, but because I'm quite pale, I don't actually mind that too much. I also mix it in with my L'Oreal True Match, so if I'm doing a full face like I'm doing today, I used this, and then I used the L'Oreal Perfect True Match foundation. I mix the two together just to give me a bit more colour when I'm doing my makeup, and then also just to give me a bit more coverage, but I absolutely love this stuff. It's got skincare benefits in it anyway, and I buy mine from Amazon, and it's cheaper. I know they sell it on Beauty Bay now and it's about £20, but I think this is a lot cheaper on Amazon, so check it out. Other things I've been enjoying is lanolin. So this is from Amazon. It's basically a great lip balm. The theory behind it is that your nipples are about the same, like, smooth level and thickness level as your lips. So I've got a little one and I've got a big one. Obviously, it's going to come in great handy for blisters and running and any other, hopefully not too much chafing. So I've been loving that. I wanted to try this out because I've heard a lot of hype about this. I think Pixie Woo, and I've seen loads of people use it over the years. It's the Embryolisse Lait Creme Concentrate. Brilliant. When I first saw it, I was a bit like, is this what the hype is? Because it is almost like a really nice smelling E45, but you can also use it. So it says it's a moisturiser, a makeup primer, and a moisturising mask. Now, I actually use this as my nighttime and daytime moisturiser, and I also use it underneath foundation, and I think it makes your foundation go on and look amazing. So I really like it. It's going to last me a long time because you only need a tiny bit. It smells really nice. It's really soothing, and I think that's what's giving my skin at the moment like even more of a kind of smoothness to it. It's pretty much the only thing that I've added in other than one other skincare product I'm going to show you, and I really recommend it. It's making my makeup last and stay smooth and my skin look glowing, so I'd highly check that out. It's up to the hype. And then my final skincare item, I've been trying to find like face oils and things because now I'm 27. Obviously I've always looked after my skin, but I think it's really important to kind of keep it looking soft and supple. I've tried a lot of like natural oils before, like coconut oil, avocado oil, and I just find that they're either too rich or they just react to my skin or they make me break out. So I thought I'd give this a go. I've heard the Kardashians like to put this on their face as well, so if it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me. And also I wanted a cheaper version, so one of my favourite old serums was a vitamin E nighttime serum in oil, and I felt that for the price it's brilliant, but then I can get something without a scent, so it's less likely to irritate my skin, and I can get like a big bottle for the same price. So I got the smaller bottle to start with, and I've been absolutely loving this. I put it on in the morning, only like on my skin itself, so I'm not overdoing it. I'll put 1 to 2 drops on my face morning and night. I use it on my hands, so it's really helping my nails to grow. I use it on my feet. I've just bought a big bottle of it for all over my body as well, just because it's really like, because it's natural. This is the Naissance Natural Vitamin E from Amazon. Again, I'll link them down below. Because it's got no scent, nothing in it other than the vitamin E oil, it's brilliant for me. There's no strong scent, so it's not irritating my skin, and again, it's just helping my skin. I don't really have any scars or anything from acne anymore, but anything that is there, I just love this. So yeah, great product. One other skincare item, I do love the grey version of this mask. This is the L'Oreal Paris Pure Clay Bright Mask with Yuzu Clay. It's a really great mask for when you want your skin to look fresh and glowy. It's got kind of like an exfoliating texture in it. It's under £5. And yeah, I just really love it. I'll probably do it tonight just to smooth my skin out, and just it brightens your skin. So I really recommend that. Makeup items, so there's a few new bits that I've been enjoying. So this isn't a new one, it's one of my favourite perfumes. I've always loved it, even as a child, but I've gone back to my old faithful Coco Chanel Mademoiselle. So Coco Mademoiselle by Chanel, sorry. I've just bought a backup, which is obviously the more modern bottle, but this is the bottle that I had, I got for my birthday a couple of years ago. I just love the smell. It smells really sexy, grown up and classy, and I just feel really good when I'm wearing it, and it lasts a long time. So I've got a backup already. This is one of my favourites. My favourite Holy Grail Red lipstick, I'm wearing it now. I haven't been pretty much wearing anything else because then I put on something else and I miss this. It's the Pro Supreme lip pigment by Revolution Pro in the shade Inconspicuous. I've just literally ordered on Makeup Revolution another 2. Just lasts all day. It's run proof, sweat proof. Obviously I ran my 10k when I was wearing this. I really like the packaging, and it's £4, so you can't go wrong. I think it's just as good as Jeffree Star. You do have to let it dry down, but I just love this red on me. If you've got dark hair and pale skin, then this is my go-to. I also discovered, I wanted to get this when I got paid, it's the P. Louise eyeshadow base, and absolutely love it. It's brilliant. I wasn't sure to begin with. I was like, oh, is this it? Because I know Nikki Tutorial said it was the best eye base ever, but it truly is, because for my eyeshadow I tend to do like a matte kind of eye, and I've got used to kind of carving out my brows with the next product, which I'll show you. But this really does give me the perfect blank canvas. It makes my eyeshadow stay on all day, and it just really helps me when I'm doing my brows, just to make sure they look nice and cut and carved out, and it's not too, it just blends really nice. I think this is the shade 02 Rumour, and I think it was only £10, so again, it's going to last me a long time, and I just love it at the moment. It's a brilliant product. It just makes your eyes look awake, ready for eyeshadow, and makes your brows look on point as well when you carve them out. My brow product that I'm loving is the Sleek Brow Pencil. Again, I'll link this down below. I think this is in the shade Dark Brown, I think it is. It doesn't actually say on here. Oh, it does. Yeah, shade Dark. I always used to use eyeshadow, but I found this is making me have like a really more precise defined brow, and I kind of been watching a lot of tutorials on how to use it. So you've got your brow pencil on one end, and then you've got your brush on the other. Under £5 again on Amazon. Really reliable, lasting me a long time, and that is one of my favourite products at the moment. Highlighter, I've been using this over the top of either my Wet n Wild highlighter in Blossom Glow or my Revolution Renaissance Illuminating Radiant Rose. They're my two highlighters that I tend to use. But I put this, after I've baked, I just put some setting spray on just so my skin isn't dry when I'm putting the liquid on. But this is the Barry M Liquid Chrome Highlighter Drops in the shade Precious Pearl. When I first saw this, I thought it was going to be white. But when you blend it out on your skin, it kind of just gives you like a pearly, like a pinky, dewy white glow, which for me again is perfect. So I use that underneath my highlighter and it just gives it a base for it to stick all day. My favourite blush at the moment, which is really pigmented, is the Wet n Wild Colour Icon Blush in Pearlescent Pink. It's this pinky peachy shade. I've heard a lot of people say it's like NARS's Orgasm. It was like £2-3 from Beauty Bay, and honestly it's so pigmented, like you can see it there. And I use this every day. It kind of gives your skin, even if you just use the highlighter drops and then put this over the top, it does give you a glow. I don't use, the only place I use bronzer is on my nose. So I tend to just use like a pinky blush just to give my skin a glow. So that is my favourite one at the moment. And it's great because it's not too expensive and you can carry it around and you don't have to worry about it getting smashed. The final item, this is my holy grail eyeshadow palette. I use it every day. I have just bought the version of it. They do like a big palette and they also do a 16 palette. But I love this because I basically have my little makeup bag and I have my makeup and my brushes in my day-to-day handbag. So this is the Beauty Bay EYN Nude Matte Palette. So it's all matte nude colours, and honestly these are the eyeshadows, the shades that I will use every day. So again, you've got your all over lid colour, you've got your transition shades, you've got a matte black, and you've got some different browns. So for every day I tend to just put the white shade all over my eye, I put one of these two shades all over, and then I will use either After Dark or Slow Motion just as a liner. Obviously if I was going out I'd probably darken it up with the black shade, but this for me is an essential palette. I absolutely love it. It's small enough for me to cart around, the mirror's nice, and I have just bought the one which is similar to this in the 16 shade just because I know it's got some shimmers in as well if I want to play. So yeah, that is all my current favourites at the moment. A little bit of everything, but it's products I've genuinely been using daily for the last few months and I'm absolutely loving them. If you did enjoy this video, please like, subscribe and comment. I'd love to know what you've been loving, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye guys.